I take you to the candy shop.
Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. I want to switch it up a little bit. I finally kind of put more stuff in my studio. I have my main desk set up with all my kind of interface stuff. And I have finally put up my first hardware keyboard, which is my Korg Kronos. Awesome sound out of it. Let me play a quick chord just to give you an idea what it sounds like. It's a really crisp sound. I'm gonna come up with a chord progression and I have to like slide halfway across the room to get there. So we're gonna, yeah, we got the machine hooked up. I know there's no visuals right now. I just don't have, 18,000 cameras to record every angle. You know, I'm hitting pads, I'm just pressing a pad. I'm not using like the complex functions of a machine here. But anyway, if you go to library, go to, I forget what this tab's called, to be honest with you. This is called the groups tab. Once you go to all groups, hit the drop down and go to types. And click on all groups. There's a drop down. And I'm starting with the Marble Rims library from Native Instruments for the machine. I really like sticking to the kits. It puts you in a certain mindset as if that's all you have is that sound. I don't like to go through 3,000 sounds when I'm on the machine. I just like the kit and I use the kit, move on. I don't use 1,000 different things. So anyway, in the Marble Rims, I'm using the one called Candy Shop. That's why I was singing Candy Shop. So we're gonna do the 50 Cent thing. Now, I used to record in machine or record, I used to record loops in the machine. There's an easier way to bypass all this software stuff. Okay, so what you do is you send it to the mixer. So you go to your channel rack, open it up, send it to channel 2, and it's on channel 2. I'm gonna open up a plugin called Edison. Edison is gonna allow me to record into audio. So I have Edison open on mixer channel 2. I'm gonna go to the dropdown and click on play. That's important because it will put time markers based on your song. And that's really important because it's easier to see the lines. You'll see what it looks like in a little bit. Anyway, I'm gonna hit record. My metronome's on 96. I'm gonna go to playlist mode so I can just see. You don't really need to be here, but this is where it's gonna end up anyway. So I'm gonna hit play. And again, Edison is set to record on play. So when I hit play, it's ready to listen. So that's all I'm gonna do is hit play now. And I'm gonna boom. So I'm playing it by hand because I want that natural human swing. There's like tiny, small little microseconds where I'm like slightly ahead or slightly behind. And that creates a really unique groove. Okay, so we're gonna send it to the playlist as an audio clip. Now you can see those little markers, those little triangle shapes help you line up your bars. So it lines up perfectly. All we have to do is go to snap to grid bar, grab your slice tool, hit shift. And I'm gonna leave, I can't tell if I hit it early. Let's see. See how? Okay, so if I would have just randomly sliced right at the bar, there's a little bit of the sound. You might not be able to see it, but a little bit of the sound comes before the bar. So I'm not going to slice that out. I'm going to leave it. So that's where an intro would be helpful. And this is where I think the art of the intro came in because, you know, the drums could play a little bit before, a little bit after. So usually if you listen to rock songs, they go, with the drumsticks, they click them together to get people ready to record. It's kind of like a pre-count. Anyway, so now we have what we have. Let's grab that slice tool, hit shift, right click, delete the little excess to the right. So now we have 4 bars of drums. And you can feel that human timing. That's gonna add a lot more life. Now let's say you wanna loop it. In that case, I would slice, but you gotta be really careful when you slice. For whatever reason, you know, the next feature I highly believe should be in FL Studio is a simple audio fade, because you need fades to avoid clicks. And I think that's a feature that's not very easy to use right now. I know there's a way to de-click and fade, but it's not, you know, the way people are used to. I think that'd be really beneficial to the FL users. Anyway, and we'll pay for the update. I mean, you know. So now we have the drums. I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna keep my metronome on just so I can keep track. Actually, let's turn the metronome off for this one. So I'm gonna play my keys. I think we're on track 3 and 4 here. Yeah, 3 and 4. So I'm gonna slide over to my keyboard. I'm gonna give myself a little time to record. So just in case, I like to record with at least 32 bars or 16 bars ready, because sometimes you mess up and you don't wanna have to go all the way back, restart it. You just wanna keep kind of pushing through rather than going all the way back. So now that's ready, I'm going to play some chords. And I'm gonna play the chords Am7, then it's gonna go to an augmented A-flat, and then we're gonna play augmented 7 A-flat, and then we're gonna do chord, then Am9 after that, and then we're gonna go to, let me figure the chords out real quick. I have to slide my chair pretty far away. So here are the chords. Okay, so I'm just kind of trying to decide on those last couple chords. So I'll show you the, man, this is a lot of sliding around. Oh man, anyway, I probably need to get a more, whatever. So those are the chords. So let's just play it with the chord progression. And notice I'm strumming the chords too. I'm not playing it like all at once. I'm playing like bring, bring. It just makes it sound a little more R&B-esque and G-funk-esque. Let's record, audio on a playlist. So that augmented chord is really saving that chord progression. I think it's probably one of my favorite tools to use for R&B is augmented chords for the turnaround. Some people call them passing chords. It just sounds really good, in my opinion. Now, I wish I would have played the sustain pedal at least to kind of hold it out, but it came a little short. Okay, so we're halfway done the track already. It's not a Prophet 6, it's actually Korg Kronos. The track is mislabeled, which is fine. Okay, so I'm just thinking of hooks or melody. Okay, so we have drums, chords, and now we're gonna lay down a lead with my my Moog Sub 37. So this one I'm gonna have to experiment with a little bit more because, let me make sure I'm arming it to record, because again, we're doing so many chord changes that I'm going out of key sometimes. So it's a little hard to like know exactly where I'm going mentally. I'm gonna stay within the A minor, which is all the white notes, but sometimes I might make a mess up. I might have a flaw somewhere in here, but it's fine. You can always cut it out. Let's just record. I might come up with a little riff, you never know. Anyway, so the point is drums, chords, Now we're doing the lead, and then I'll do my bass line, and then we'll wrap it up with vocal. Moving pretty quick. And I realized I gotta turn my mic off because I can't hear the my setup doesn't reach, so I gotta turn my speakers on louder. So for that section, I'm not really obsessed about every little part I played. I just want something that I can take away and know that I'm actually going to use it. So again, I don't want the lead to be throughout the whole track. Just go back, hear what sounds good. Then I'll cut it out. Kind of like it right there, and then let's cut it off right where I kind of my finger didn't reach. Let's cut it right there. That's enough, and then we can turn it down. The rest was just kind of whatever. I don't really care for it too much. Let me get rid of this track. So you can see, once you have like a process, it's you're not overthinking every little thing, you know. It's just like, okay, we got the drums, okay, now we got the chords, okay, now we got the lead, now we're moving forward. So now we're on to the bass, which I have a Moog Voyager for the bass to get that funky sound. So I'm gonna tuck the lead behind the track. I don't want it to dominate. Gotta make sure we're naming stuff, chords. Making sure the synth lines up. Okay, the synth's just really tucked in the back. Might add guitar, I'm not sure yet, because I don't play guitar chords off the top of my head. It would take me too long to think about guitar chords. It's always something we can add later. Actually, I think there's a library. Let me see if I can get that in key. It needs to be. Let's see if this matches. Okay, let's record that. I like that. I forgot that was in that library. This is from the machine. Let's do new, record on play. And that will be our guitar. I forgot I was listening to all the drums. So this, I forgot to reroute that. So we got to do that one more time. Record on play. A little off, but I'm going to line it up. Anyway, send it to the playlist. And it's about to play in Edison. All I gotta do is just move it a little to the left because it has somewhat of an attack. Let's get rid of that. I'm just gonna grab my pencil tool, hit Alt to micro shift stuff. It needs to be a little bit further to the left. Works for me, and then we can add effects to it. Let's send that to track 5, mixer channel 5. Let's call this guitar effect. Can't spell guitar FX. Then add a simple delay, Fruity Delay 3. Let's do ping pong, pan it out a little bit. It's a little early, so again, it's like microseconds off. It's just a matter of getting it timed properly. It's better for the ear that something's a little delayed than a little more ahead of the curve. It sounds more pleasing. So let's move that over here. I'm gonna do one more thing with the chords, which is to use like a West Coast chord effect. You play the chord, then you use the pitch wheel to slide the chord up. Sounds really good on Rhodes piano and any kind of sine-based synth. All right, so let me go back to the keys and record that. Two seconds, I got it. There we go. It turned something off. Let's go back to our keyboard. 3 and 4. And then we're gonna add that West Coast effect that you're used to. Recording those little vibrato chords. Make sure we're on the track to record the keys. I'm just playing A minor and E minor. Excuse me, A minor and G major. Actually, I switched it between the A minor, G major, and then the triad of the augmented because it just sounds cooler. I thought it was gonna be hard to play with three fingers, but it was easier than I thought. So I'm just gonna cut out parts I don't like. Think about your guitar vibrato. It's the same thing, but with keys. Okay, so let's just slide that over. Make sure we're lined up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it starts around the 6th chord that we play. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It looks about right. Okay, so now let's get to the bass, which is going to be the most iconic sound. So we're gonna have to kind of play around with the bass, because again, I can't take my setup that far away. I have to turn my speakers on, so I have to turn down my microphone. Okay, so we have a couple ideas for the bass. I was just playing little small ideas. Let's unmute that. And what we need now are just shakers and hi-hats. We'll wrap it up with vocals. So just keep it simple. I didn't realize it was leaning so hard to the left. So let me figure out. Just make this a mono track. Pull that. Mono. So in the beginning, I didn't like that bounce. I like this part. I like it when it's on the downbeat with the kicks, not in between the kicks. Playing a little early. Kind of like that. Like that. This could be a change up. I like these. A little early though, we're gonna move it. Section I didn't like was that small beginning part. Let's figure out what this is. Okay, so right now I have to figure out the timing. It's a little odd because I'd started off in the middle of nowhere with the bass line, so now I have to align stuff to make sense time-wise. Let me move these around. It's kind of, in my head, I have three different things. I have intro, I have the intro thing, then I have the section A thing, and then I have the section B of the bass. That's how I'm thinking of it mentally. So now I'm looking at, okay, we have however many bars. I have section A, section B. Now we should be able to duplicate this without going over, but it looks like I went over by a little bit, which is fine. We'll just cut out the end. And again, it's a little early, so I'm just going to highlight everything. Hit Alt Right to micro nudge. That was a little late. come up with a pattern for the hi-hats. So again, we're just gonna record one good take. Forgot what I had in my head already. But anyway, open up Edison. Let's go new. Record on play. Very beginning, send it to playlist. Messed up a little bit towards the end, that's fine. Name this percussion. So now all we gotta do is just chop that, loop that. So now we have high frequencies. So now the bass won't sound so loose. Reason I'm doing this is because I don't know if that very beginning of the audio is overlapping, so I don't want it to cut it off, even though it cuts itself off when it overlaps the audio. If it mutes out right here, then I'll know I need to cut that out. See how even the hi-hats don't match up with the timing? It's because I played the drums by hand for however long and the timing's all different, so you can't just really copy and paste that. I'm probably going to do it longer this time for 4 bars instead of just 2 bars. See, that's small, those small little time differences mean so much. You could tell that it doesn't line up. Record by on play. I'm gonna pick up during the next, so I know where the drums come in. So now that has my full groove to it, all the little micro timing decisions. That's why it's so hard to illustrate that when we're making boom bap. But that should work better than that loop I had before. Small little time differences make a huge difference, especially in these unquantized genres. Synthesizers. I don't really hear another synth on this. Let me mess around with the preset for a little bit. We'll be right back. So I might even pull out a plugin that sounds dated, but it sounds dated in a good way. It doesn't sound like you're never going to use it dated. It just has those sounds from a very specific time period. It's called Expand 2. I really like the, you know, like the synth patches in here. I mean, string patches is what I meant to say. They have brass patches in here. Let's click the down. Let's go to strings and let's just test these out. Strings are usually really good for, West Coast. I need to turn my MIDI on. Cool thing about MIDI is I played a note a little too early, which is fine. All I gotta do is just quantize it because I don't have the metronome playing, so it's hard to just guess when the drums are coming in. Now we gotta come up with a vocal. Has to be more of a rappy vocal, not like a Nate Dogg vocal. Unless we do that note. Might be cool. Let's try that. Where are you at? Free notebook. Where are you at? Notebook. Grown up with a So let me get the hook right.
Roll up with a friend who got his cheese. Roll up.
Make sure I'm getting all the words down so I don't have to do it 8 times.
Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who sound like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up.
It was gonna say roll up. Okay, so now I got it. Let's record. I suggest probably using a high pass filter if you can on your mic, because my voice is a little bit deeper, so I need to cut out those low frequencies while I'm recording. Usually I don't, I'll do it in post, but I just sound better when I'm doing a lot of harmonies with the high pass filter on. Turn my speakers off. Okay, so again, let me turn the, trying to decide, should I use the metronome? In this case, trying to see what it looks like. If I don't use the metronome, I'm going to end up recording like a bar in. I don't want to do that. So I have to use the metronome only to align the vocal, but it's not going to sound, like it's timed correctly in the beginning. Also, this text is really small. Is there any way to make it bigger? I have no idea. Super hard to see from back here. Can we zoom in? Oh, we can zoom in. Let's go. Did not know that until now. Okay, let's record. Make sure we're on our mic track. Arm for recording. Record audio into playlist. And I like to keep my lyrics somewhere, you know, to the side. If you don't trust the playlist or whatever, slide your notebook over here. And then you do that. So you can see it. Okay, go back to your mic. Record. Audio into playlist is an audio clip.
Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that sound like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up. Roll up.
I'm a little pitchy every now and again, but we're not going to use autotune because that's going to make it sound too robotic and fake. So I left a couple flaws in there, like when I was running out of breath, I was like, roll up, you know, I had to like breathe. So if I had to push all the air out of my diaphragm so I could breathe, and it caused a note error, which is fine. So all I'm going to do now is look at these and see which one, what am I trying to say? Which each take. So I can tell visually because it goes roll up, roll up. So I could tell right here at the end where they're kind of ad libs, I'll cut right there. Then it starts the new thing. So that's an easy way to know where the next take is. Now what I'm going to do is make each unique because I have to. And I'll let it play back, but I'll mute my mic.
Roll up with a player who got his cheese.
That was kind of a cool sound effect. It was the squeakiness of my chair. But it's like it's a different style intro. I think that's pretty cool, actually. I'm going to leave that in. Only thing is I want to separate it because I don't want to process it through a compressor and all that. So I'm going to separate that. But I like that intro. You're like, what? It sounds like a zipper or something. Anyway, let's just call this sound effect. And we're going to make all these unique and just rename them. So call this take one. Notice how I didn't rename this stuff. Okay, so we have to make this unique. Call this take two. The reason we're making it unique is because we don't want it to, in FL Studio, it considers everything the same audio take. I don't know why it's built that way. It just is. So even though I'm making these slices, it still considers it the same take. Let's call it take three. Take four. Then all I'm going to do is stack these up. Take one, two, three, and four. Again, I'm not going to go hyper ridiculous with the editing here. I'm just going to compress it, add an EQ, do what we got to do. Okay, so it's going to be loud. So what I'm going to do is send these to track 8, 9, 10, 11, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And then we're going to pan one hard left, one hard right, then one kind of 50% left, one 50% right. Now, if you're really into vocal production, I would actually go back and do another take so we can keep it mono. In this case, I'm not going to be ridiculous.
Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up.
So, now I'm going to go a little bit faster. I'm going to turn off my mic because I have to turn my speakers on. And I'm just going to mix the vocal really quickly just to make it sound cool. And then we'll see if we're going to add a verse or anything.
Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up. Roll up.
West Coaster, you can add a vocoder or a talk box, like you know, the Daft Punk type of sound.
Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese.
If this sound becomes too obnoxious, normalized, then I'm gonna
roll up.
So here's what I'll do. I'll make it unique as a sample. Save that. Let's call it sound effect. It sounds like an intro to a movie or something, or like, you know, it sounds like we're in a scene. That's why I like it so much. Anyway, where is it at? Double click on it. So now it's isolated by itself.
Roll up.
And I want to fade it stereo wise.
Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll roll up. Roll up. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up.
Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Now roll up. Now roll up. Now roll up. Now roll up. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Now roll up. Roll up with a player who roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player. The player who got his cheese. The roll up. Roll up. The roll up. The roll up. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. The roll up. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Now roll up. Now roll up. Now roll up. Now roll up. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese.
I'll give you these project stems, which means I'll group the bass, I'll group the drums, I'll group the, what else did we use in here? The melody and the chords. I'll put each into its own thing. So there'll be one main track with chords, one main track with melody, one main track with vocals, one main track with, you know, all the drums combined. So they're called stems.
Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Now roll up. Now roll up. Now roll up. Now roll up. Now roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player that's hot like me. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up with a player who got his cheese. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up. Roll up.
So thanks for watching. Again, you're going to get these project stems below. Just click that link below to get them for free. Be sure to confirm your email so that you can get the email with the download link actually in it. Okay, thanks for watching today. Again, click that link below to get these project stems for free. It's busyworksbeats.com. I think we're going to put it at busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. Okay, so thanks for watching. It's busyworksbeats.com.